You're watching Mighty Machines on Carlson 15, and this is the final part of my comparison video series about two chairlifts that are three decades apart. In this part, we're going to look at the mechanical brains of each of the chairlifts, at the service track that's used to take out damaged chairs, at a few interesting facts about the rope, and of course, the garroting procedure. In my previous videos, you have already learned what happens in the numerous mechanics that are installed in a ropeway station. Meanwhile, down in the control room, each station's operator watches over the passengers.
Wie viel müsst ihr eingreifen, wenn etwas passiert?
Ja, hier liegen wir nicht so viel. Ich muss sagen, wenn viel los ist, so vielleicht 3-4 Mal pro Tag maximal.
Was sind so die häufigsten
Unfälle? Ja, meistens, dass sie irgendwo mit dem Rucksack da hängen bleiben, im Sessel.
If they are getting in danger, he stops the lift immediately, in this case just for demonstration. This shot was taken on the upper station, so a phone call must be issued to the lower station in order to restart the ropeway.
Ah, da kannst du weiterfahren. Gut, ciao.
The wait for the lift to start back up reminds me of a question I've had for a long time. Why does it take so long for a ropeway to start up? To find out, let's look at the control systems. Each station has a controller where all sensors are connected to. Can you imagine the cable management? The tidy control panels hide an incredibly complex electromechanic brain. For instance, this is the cabinet responsible for communicating with the other station.
Ja, ich sehe jetzt zum Beispiel die Orange, die vom Vormittag ist gefragt hat, die Initiatoren, die Orange Kästchen, die Schalter. Das sind jetzt die.
Also wir können hier zuschauen, wie das Essen durchfahren.
Ja, genau. Die Blendine. Wenn ich jetzt eine auslöse, dann sollte hier das rote LED leuchten. Das sind die Impulse, die du hast, wenn du ins Essen einpacken. Dann haben wir hier eigentlich die erste Fehleranzeige. Also, dass wir hier eine Fehlernummer ausschreiben. Mhm. Dann muss ich eigentlich hier auf der Liste schauen, was ist für eine Nummer ist. Und dann kommt mir hier geschrieben, was für ein Fehler ist. Das sind Sicherheitsstromkreise, heißen die. Also bevor wenn du startest, geht die Bahn, geht die Stromkreise durch. Und das ist eigentlich die Funktion von diesen ganzen Sicherheitseinrichtungen. Das ist, und dich entschalten. Und dann geht es durch, wenn alle in alle Richtungen gut sind, dann gibt es nachher im Befehl für die Bahn zu starten.
So the startup delay is due to the machine performing a self-check. To demonstrate it, Cyril stops the chairlift. It's all built from relays, so the startup is quite spectacular.
Ich habe nur gerade gestartet, du siehst auch, wie das da
Cyril then issues another stop to let me record the startup from this side of the panel. Good old relay technology built in 1986. Alec from the YouTube channel Technology Connections would certainly love that. Finally, on this panel, we see the measurement of the pressure test for the clamp wheels. Isn't that a lovely little interface for such a specific task? Well, as you can probably guess, the steering systems look very different in the Bartoli lift from 2017, so let's go have a look at them. The sensors are connected to several programmable logic controllers, or PLCs, that are interconnected through a complex bus system. This way, the thousands of cables connecting the sensors only need to go to the nearest PLC, in contrast to the older lift that had all wires going all the way to the central control system. The detail of the measurements is absolutely stunning. For instance, here you can see the pressure in each of the two cylinders that keep the rope under tension. What was represented by the little green LEDs in the older ropeway, namely the position of each chair as it moves along the station, have given way to this virtual panel on this touchscreen. The numbers in the middle represent the amount of impulses received by the indicators.
Du siehst zum Beispiel, wenn wir nachher ins 2 kommen, Sektion 2, jetzt hat er 46 Impulse gehabt, bis er ist durch gewesen.
Boah.
Und Nennwert ist 46, also ist er genau Wenn wir nachher in diesen Grenzen über die Grenzwerte überschreiten, dann haben wir nachher, dann kommt nachher eine Fehlermeldung. Dann merkt die Bahn, der Sessel ist zu schnell oder zu langsam. Und dann gibt es euch einen Tag.
With the current configuration, the chairs are supposed to be 56 meters apart. If they are not, the distances are corrected in section number 7. This chair came in 2 impulses late, so the ropeway moves it a little bit faster to correct for the delay. The next chair is only 1 impulse late, so it's corrected a little bit less. This is achieved by spinning the motors that we saw earlier a little faster or slower than usual. As shown in my earlier video, the impossible garaging procedure that actually exists, the motors also accelerate the chairs, and that can be seen very well here. The masts are also equipped with sensors, and it all comes together at the computer. The whole system must be tested regularly and provides special measurement modes for each test. Under normal operation, this screen is only used in order to monitor the current state and past events of the ropeway. But it also provides tools to address troubleshooting in case of a technical malfunction. So I asked Cyril, what would the procedure be in such a case?
Ich habe einen Fehler gefunden, aber ich kann ihn nicht in einer gewissen Zeit beheben. Dann ist überbrücken, also wenn ich darf, und dann ist die Bahn leer fahren. Und dann muss ich nachher einen Fehler beheben. Und dann kann ich hier auch gewisse Sachen überbrücken, einfach immer hier mit diesen Schlüsselschaltern zusammen. Wenn der Bildschirm nicht funktioniert, kann ich darum gleich noch mit der Bahn fahren. Mhm. Es gibt dann auch gewisse Knöpfe und so, die man kann betätigen kann, dass man darum gleich fahren kann.
The system also contains an extensive automatic error log that provides a detailed description of the nature of the error. It even links to the datasheet of the affected components. In this case, it's a signal loss from the radio controller. This controller allows the operator to be outside of the control room and still access the essential controls for operating the ropeway.
I can even mark the Sessel, so that he knows that there is something coming. I have to look at it especially. I can go faster and slower. I can quit and start. And here is naturally the Nothalt. The Nothalt is just so that there is eigentlich das Funksignal unterbrechen. Mhm. Einfach, dass du die Sicherheitsstandard kannst einhalten kannst. Und dann die Antenne, und dann haben wir hier das Sicherheitsrelais da, wo die Signale auswertet vom Funk.
If a problem results in the shutdown of the ropeway, the telephone can be used to perform a speaker announcement. Pre-recorded texts are available in several languages, such as a small defect, a longer disruption, the announcement that a recovery team is on the way, or that the electrical power was lost. The message is then played through this amp over the speakers attached to the masts. In order to deal with a malfunctioning chair, a service track is used. Such a track exists on the top station as well as on the bottom station of each of these 2 chairlifts. This procedure has barely changed in the past 30 years.
Vorne in der Station die Sicherheitseinrichtung, die Blenden auslösen, wenn du es willst, ein Schatten, ein Flemmo oder wenn das Flemmo nicht mehr schön um sich schliessen, auslösen, die Einrichtung, die Sicherheitseinrichtung. Dann muss man eigentlich das Ganze nochmal testen. Wenn die Sicherheitseinrichtung nochmal auslösen, muss man das Sessel nochmal aushängen und dann muss man dann hier entwickeln, oder?
Dann nimmst du die Klemme zum Teil ganz oben an.
Ja, je nachdem, wenn du dann noch etwas ist, dann liegt die hier zum Licht und hier verloren und im Fahrstoff.
Mit dem Radtrag.
Fun fact, each ropeway's rope is unique. My friends from the US would say cable, but it's just another word for the same thing. Such ropes are extremely durable and they often last through the chairlift's whole lifetime. However, over the years, a rope gets longer and longer until the mechanism holding it under tension approaches its limits. That is when it's time to make the rope shorter. To my surprise, this can be done by simply cutting a piece out and splicing the 2 ends back together. The new Bartoli lift has a more elegant solution for this. While the tension is applied in the bottom station, the top station also has the ability to pull back the yellow wheel. This is done by using this manual hydraulic press and then adjusting the 2 threaded rods holding the assembly in place. This mechanism achieves the same effect as removing a piece from the rope, but the process is much easier. On this lift, it already had to be adjusted once. If a small section of the rope is damaged and needs to be replaced, the replacement must be an exact fit for the splicing to work. The operators cannot just ring the rope's manufacturer and order a new piece of it, as the manufacturer would have to reconfigure their machines to the unique exact same parameters that were in effect at the time when the rope was produced. So the operators just keep around a piece of spare rope and take out bits of that rope whenever a patch must be replaced. It's getting late, the entrance door is shut, and the staff has initiated the Garaventa's garaging procedure. The lift down the stairs is motorized, everything else must be done manually. This is Monsters, Inc. all over again, but decades older. There is more to hear and see than to say here, so I'll just turn on the audio and let you immerse into the experience. When the garaging is complete, the chairlift is shut down for the night. The large room gets very quiet, and the stacked chairs are somewhat uncanny. Not all chairs are here though, a convoy of 5 chairs is left at the bottom station. They are used, for instance, by the snow groomer drivers, who can operate the chairlift in the remote control mode to get to and from their vehicles. In the next morning, the process is gonna be reversed, and the chairs are sent up through the other stairs. The coordination of the staff must be perfect to match the chairlift's clocking. To make it work, the staff member on the bottom must send up a chair exactly when a finger on the main chain appears. The garaging of the Bartoli lift works in a completely different way. It is so unique and sophisticated that I dedicated an entire video to it, so at this point let me simply refer to that video, the impossible garaging procedure that actually exists. And that concludes this chairlift comparison. I hope you enjoyed and would like to say a huge thank you to the Lauchernalp staff, in particular to Cyril for dedicating an entire day to make this video possible. I might have overdone it a little bit with the extent. Let me know in the comments whether you appreciate that or if you would prefer rather shorter, more focused videos. And with that, I bid you goodbye and see you when the next video project is ready for uploading. Have a great day.